fucking full Dacker build he's got. Oh, Jesus.
Hello.
Something like that. Python, Python.
So what did I say? 162 jumps away I am, yeah?
Yeah.
About that, 165.
Yeah, so...
Full power.
So if I was to jump from where I am, straight back home, I could be there in like 3 hours.
Oh, easy.
Easy. But
you are not going to know what to do with yourself when you get back.
Sorry?
You're not going to know what to do with yourself when you get back.
I'm going to be a lost cause when I get back, I think.
Combat, or you can just turn around and go back out.
Yeah. Well, I want to work on the combat rank, get that to elite, because I've only got like one left there, I think. One or two ranks left.
Any of that around?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure, what we're doing right now.
I want to do some engineering, I hope. And get me a fleet carrier. And then I'll reconsider about going back out again. Because I actually don't mind being out here in the black.
That's quite nice.
That's not the beacon. Click clipper.
Lean, unfortunately.
Is that a phantom?
Yep.
It's good not having to worry about ammo.
So with the path, sorry.
Go for it.
I was just going to say, with the path I'm taking, it'll probably take me about 4 or 5 hours to get back home.
Yeah, you'll have to let me know when you are, and let you know what systems could do with data.
No,
most of our systems are looking really damn good at the moment.
Nice. Up to last night, I had about 120 million worth of data on my ship at the moment.
Yeah, also check when you hand that in, what our ranking goes up to in the leaderboards.
Oh, yeah.
I never checked that.
When we're out in Colonia, we got to 7, and we've dropped to 8.
Might want to run there a bit. We've taken the heat off for you. When you're getting shot at and not shot at, just reboot and repair to get your shields back. Cool.
You get them back quicker if you reboot?
Yeah, just do a reboot and repair and your shields will come back to 50%.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Just don't do it when you're being shot at.
Yeah, don't do it while you're being shot at.
And be stationary as well.
Yeah, zero throttle. Because if you're moving and everything goes offline, and when you come back online,
leak clipper.
Are you got a leak clipper?
Did you get into the TAFE, Tavares?
I did.
Oh, you did.
I was gonna
well
give
done.
A call on Monday and finalise the application and send the money.
Congratulations.
Give you some kind of discount.
I think it's around $1,000, something like that.
Because I think they're only doing certain. Certain courses were getting discounted.
Yeah,
like
really
relevant.
Sure. Apparently it's relevant, because didn't get in the first round and I got in the second round. And I'm saying, what are they called? Arborists are highly in demand at the moment. I was like, yeah, I don't want to do that.
Okay.
And to get into that, you need your cert 2 and 3 in horticulture.
Yep.
Rather grow things then, cut them down.
Well, that would be better for the planet overall.
We don't need trees to breathe, remember?
Is it going to be online or?
I think part of it's online. I won't really know until I get the course information. But there'll be classroom stuff, I think some modules online, and then practicals.
Just depends if they switch,
I guess.
We're pretty good over here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Good. We're what, getting close to 11 months with no community cases?
Transmission, nice. Yeah. It's good.
That's awesome. That's all thanks to our, partly luck and the hard border we had.
I'm just rearming. Be back in a sec.
So he's.
Yep.
Well, Wesley's got his carrier still here, so.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know if he came back with us, or if he's still in Colonia.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Got an elite asp.
Energy weapons don't need ammo, so I'm good.
Oh, as long as I'm not dropping into and dropping out of super crews. This is weird.
Yeah, you
nav locked.
No.
Everyone except for Acton zero throttle. And see if you jump out.
I am.
Because if we all throttle down to zero, it's just going to pull you out of super cruise.
Yep, I keep getting pulled back to the to that beacon.
Okay,
yeah, so
on your wing icons, is there a square around any of them?
Yeah, around you. Yeah.
Yep, your nav locked.
So just click on Tavares' name and disable wingman nav lock.
Oh, shot the rocket. How rude.
Romano, I need to get some prismatics for my Sidewinder as well.
Yes, that's what I need to do.
Yeah.
I thought I had some on there, but I must have pulled them off.
I don't know where they're gone, yeah. Like, I swear I had prismatics on the Sidewinder, because... I want to play with my proxy mine, the engineered proxies again, because those were fun. Not very practical, but just fun.
It's just a lot of fun. Oop.
So there's been a few systems. Sorry, I'll keep cutting your stick.
Nah, used to it. Go for it.
What, you saying that I do it to you all the time?
Yeah, I'm used to it. Ow.
Nature of the voice channel.
Yeah,
I'm used to Discord, so yeah.
Yeah.
Go for it. What's this?
I think we all do it to each other in a way. Yeah, I've forgotten what I was going to say. So because I'm not finding much Earth-like worlds, or I've been finding a ton of water worlds, I've been randomly just scanning any old system to try and get me a mount up. Like the data amount up and that.
Type 7 has just been picking up shit that people have been dropping.
Sneaky.
Just so I don't come back empty handed, sort of thing.
Not anymore, because I just fucking blow it up. Trajectory disruption. I like my engines.
Well, it wasn't me that time.
Bounce.
To get my Type 10 and just put turrets on it. Just sit here and fire at will.
Oh, killbacks.
I've got one of those.
Is that an Anaconda? Alright, now we're gonna have to kill this. Sorry, Conrad. Oh, he's deployed a fighter, look at it.
Oh, he is one.
Quick, row yourself out. These things, the killbacks, man, in Colonia were just everywhere.
They might make my pirate ship one of those.
Just for shits and giggles?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what are you still on, missions or bounty hunting? What?
Just bounty hunting.
Oh, okay. What, had a nav bacon or?
Yeah.
In Kajara. No. The compromised nav.
Yeah. By the sound of it, that one's actually pretty popular. Got another killback.
For elite ships, yeah. It's where you come to get your elite rank.
Oh, okay.
And I have an adjuster following me.
Nice. Bring him in and we'll send him on his way. Or in pieces. Whichever comes first.
I can shoot that blue stuff at me. Fucking see yourself roll. Out. Take that, you piece of shit. I copped a few of your pack hounds, Sam.
Bad.
Anaconda.
There is? Yes.
Might be in a wing. Yeah, with a Challenger. With a Crusader? Challenger. Ooh, rubber band.
Fuck you and your chef. Let me fix that for you.
Yes, let me get rid of his shield.
Don't know why you're still banking, mate. You don't have shields anymore.
Huh.
Animation is broken. He's gonna jump. He's gone.
Worse. Gonna go run back to his mummy and daddy. They're bigger than me!
I think his engines are dead.
Fucking acting.
What the fuck's going on? Just let me. Yeah, his drives are at 0%, that's why. Everyone's here now, it's a party. Alright.
And
Why wasn't the Challenger being helped? Like, ah, that's why.
One adjuster served medium rare.
Oops, sorry.
All good.
If you don't fines, and you just have to go to. Oops.
No, you shouldn't, because it's compromised nav beacon and it's a, what's it call it? Power play shit.
And
I'll get a bounty payout for it.
How much bounties you got? I got 20 mil.
17.
31, but I've been going for a while.
Wow. How long have you been going for, Acton?
About an hour longer than everyone else here.
Okay.
Definitely a lot more profitable. Is it wanted? Or Phantom? Poor Jesus Christ. I think I put too much garlic.
Never too much garlic.
Is that what stinks?
Yeah.
I can smell it through the microphone. Thanks. Rather, the headset.
I didn't get a hit on that. Don't know. I helped.
And I'm gonna need some ammo, I think.
I think that's oh shit. Might have to go do the Corrado Scrambles after this. Go engineer them.
Don't do any engineering on all those bits and pieces, just collect them at the moment.
Ow.
Then I'll figure out a build for it all.
That's where I should be. I should be in my mining cutter at the moment. Just with all the collectors out, picking up all these engineering materials.
I've got collectors on this. I always forget to put limpets on.
Nah, I can't do that because that takes away my shield, my Corvette.
I got plenty of shields on this. The two new shield cell banks do absolute wonders. Had to get rid of my chaff though. Needed space for another heat sink.
I've never had chaff or heat sinks on my Corvette, all shield boosters.
Is there a bit of lag in the game tonight or what?
Now and then.
I've just had a couple of instances jump coming out of the frame shift drive that just freezes for a couple of seconds.
Yeah, it was
good. Yeah, mine's doing it now.
The
and then.
Beacon.
Alright. Daily list, how's everyone looking?
Completely gun checked. Wing, 1 of 2.
I think most of it's good. Zalek did the runs for me the last couple of days and I just did the orders in the morning. I don't know if he's checked minor factions or anything like that.
I'm just going to dump mine in 1597. I think we're 48% or something in there.
Yeah, because 1597, that had a slightly low security.
It had low security?
No, it wasn't low, but it wasn't high, if that makes sense. It was just into the good, a bit lower than everyone else.
Okay, is it on its way down or neutral?
All I saw was just a bit lower than the others. I didn't look at a previous day comparison, sorry.
When you jump in there, you'll have a little arrow next to it. Red pointing down if it's going down, which means someone's either doing anti-missions in there or someone's actually killing the security.
Yeah, I should make it. It says it's all solid lines.
Oh yeah, we got the Wharf and Nova Alliance. Let's go fight that.
Good.
Yeah, I might do a bit of that.
Make sure I have.
Where's sitting at?
Mono faction.
Seven.
That's a star, that's a star, that's a star. Warm, warm. Thank you.
Oh yeah, they're on close defeat. 2 vs 3.
Who's this? Nova?
Nova, yeah.
Are they winning or losing?
Losing.
What the fuck is this in announcements? See that,
might do that and go move the carrier there. I'm assuming most people have got their stuff off the thing now. Should hand these in.
Sentinels Escort. Next episode. I don't know who that is.
Sentinels? They're yeah. Allies.
Alright. Shouldn't that shit be posted in Trips and Stories? Shouldn't that be renamed back now to Trips and Stories? Seeing that Colonia is done now.
I suppose so.
Still haven't received an apology yet.
You haven't?
Nah. Probably not going to. He's in his head that he thinks he's right, and so I'm not going to argue. I just don't engage, just ignore.
Yeah. Well, tried talking to him about it, but wasn't really interested in listening.
Then, how did he get that promotion then? If he's like this, then.
That wasn't entirely up to me either.
Yeah. Zorba needs to spend more time with people, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
What did I miss?
Nothing.
Fill me in.
It's all good. It's just a little disagreement, so it's fine.
I got the gist that someone got a promotion and they don't deserve it by the sound of it.
Oh, just... Yeah, just,
Yeah, okay.
They do and they don't. It's...
No,
you develop a sixth sense for knowing what conversations to not listen to after a while, shall we say, working in the corporate world after a while.
No, I get it. Some people don't deserve a promotion, like,
yeah. He's willing to do the job, he's doing the job, but he's just, yeah, not doing it. Doing it? I don't know how to explain it.
In other words, he doesn't deserve it. You either do the job properly, or you don't.
I've noticed a few people leaving, actually, in reception.
Yeah, not sure what's about that.
Is
this dialogue?
Oh, fucking hell.
You didn't have to go there.
I think asking people for a voice interview when they just come is too intimidating.
Yeah.
But I've said my bit, I'm gonna shut the fuck up, bye.
I think that's what intimidates some people, is being forced to have a conversation. But yeah, needs to reword his welcome message, and yeah, it needs to change a few things. Some people don't have problems with it, and some do. Contacts. What do we got? I like how I can still claim my salary. Woo!
It's nice how that carries over between the powers.
Yeah.
And if you completely leave a power, it just sits there in your transactions and you can't do anything about it.
Alright, don't worry about HR 1597, I think we're good. I just dropped 21 mil in there. That should raise it.
I need to change some K bonds on me HOTUS, I think.
What the fuck is the pop size in here?
Not that big.
Oh, fuck. Garlic, man, fucking tastes good. You don't
need Parker's repeat on me.
450 mil. Oh, that's what I could have fucking went for tonight.
I've had it about 3 times in the last couple of weeks. Just because it's easy.
Yeah.
Where am I gonna go? Bounties.
Fuck was I gonna do? What's the time? I go back to my carrier and go play Satisfactory for the next...
What's that game like?
Next 8 hours. I'll go to bed at like probably 10 o'clock in the morning again. It's fun. Then, it's like, you need this certain material to advance to unlock the next tier of production, unlocks and stuff. Okay. So you have to build like mega factories just to do that one thing. So it's always a process of dismantling everything. And once you get the next stage unlocked is, oh, look, I got new buildings that can, or new recipes and shit that can make this with a lot less material. So you're always disassembling and reassembling.
Oh, okay.
What I've just done is, I found a new area where I'm building a second base now, because my plan is to have bases scattered all around that do certain tasks, like certain materials and that.
Yeah.
And have like a mega tower or something in the middle.
Oh, okay.
It's fun, but it's very time consuming, and you have to use your brain.
Yeah.
Because you got to think about load balancing and. It's like I spent, what was it? I think it was yesterday or the day before. I spent the entire day building this one factory that I got into bed. As soon as I closed my eyes, I'm like, I know how to redesign this better. So the next day, I just dismantled it all and rebuilt it. It's like, fuck you, brain. Why can't you think of this while I'm building it?
I've watched a couple of videos on it. It does look like a pretty cool game.
What is it? I'm Kibitz. Does some really good... good videos. But yeah, it's fun. If you like,
How big's the game world in it, like?
I'll be able to show you once I log in. It's pretty big.
So it's like a sandbox, obviously.
Yeah.
Considering booting up, Cyberpunk with that new patch.
Oh, they released a new patch?
Yep. An actual patch, not a hotfix.
Need to refill?
Sure thing.
Copy and reset. Make sure that is correct. Yep.
If I do that, means I have to drag all my bloody flight sim shit out from the computer.
GOG, where the fuck are you? Fucking message from PayPal. It's like, do you recognize this transaction? It's been flagged as fraudulent. I'm like, oh, what? It was my GOG purchase for Cyberpunk. Because I used a VPN to tunnel in somewhere in Russia to get the discounted price.
Yeah, that would generally send up a few flags.
Yeah.
I use PayPal once and it, I using it with a VPN, and that actually locked me out of my account. I had to contact PayPal to get unlocked again. And I said, oh, were you using a VPN or something? I'm like, yeah, I was actually. And I said, yeah, it can cause problems with it. So, just a word of warning.
That's how I get some games cheap, is you just VPN into Russia.
No.
Because hacking there, game exploitation is a big thing, so they offer games cheaper to deter them from cracking the game and shit.
Okay.
That's, yeah.
Sensei, remember you can go to the EDA First Strike, it's a carrier right nearby, if that's what you want to do.
I was filtering for stations only, thanks.
Yes, occasionally having carriers can be useful. and not distracting, occasionally.
Yeah, we try and deploy the EDA carriers around where they're actually needed, especially systems with only outposts. So then us with large ships can go restock and then get back into what we're doing.
Fair.
Makes it a lot easier. Before you'd have to jump system or move your ships to another station in an adjacent system.
And or have to wait for pads.
Yep.
Yeah, so that little trick we use at outposts doesn't work at stations.
I'm going to clear my name though because of that shot I made on the whoever it was, not a wanted guy.
Well, the power play stuff, you shouldn't have got a fine for that.
Are you aligned to any power play?
Yeah. That's probably why.
That's right, there should be some, whatchamacallits?
Can I double check?
Cell effector.
Whether or not I have a bounty on me?
So it should be under your transactions.
Ooh. They may have fixed my problem. It's updating still. Hurry up, go!
Yeah, Kuntilik has a bounty on me.
Okay.
You want to look for an interstellar factor.
Yeah, because you don't have notoriety, you can hand it in at one of our systems. We should have one. Let me have a look for you.
Wasn't going to... Kajara one?
No.
No.
So it looks like Cunty has one, it's probably Hughes.
Interstellar factors move around.
There's one there. Soidam.
Yeah.
I thought that was static.
Yeah, there's one there and you can dock there. Use that. Make sure you do it through interstellar factors, not the general contacts.
Contacts, yeah.
Because otherwise, if you do it in the contacts, it'll send you to prison. But if you do it through interstellar factor, you just pay it off and that's it.
So is that a separate menu item?
No, so it'll be under the context menu, and yeah. You'll have the, what's it called? It'll be listed as its own thing. So you open up context, and it should be towards the bottom. You'll have interstellar factors, and you just want to go into that service.
Alright, Square, I got it up and running.
Yep, just give me a sec, I'm, just entering warp space.
Oh, shit. There we go. I don't have my jetpack on, do I? Oh, fuck. System scan complete. I should be able to survive this fall.
Maybe it's last words.
I survived. I'm good.
Oh.
fucking whinging little fucking shit.
Family?
Yeah, fucking having a whinge because they want me to go up with sister's partner. Because, you know, Amanda doesn't want a risk of getting quarantining. I'm like, well, you shouldn't have. What's pissing me off is they're doing this now when Mum flies in like an hour.
Oh, you kidding?
Like, and he was just fucking yelling at me. I was like, no, you had more than enough fucking time to organize this. You agreed to it. Don't wait till the last fucking second. I'm gonna get hell for this tomorrow, but I said I'm not fucking going anywhere.
No. Where did they want you to go to?
Just to the airport with
Okay.
Instead of my sister going, I'll just go with that. I wanted me to go with my sister's partner.
Because
he can just go stay in. They got a unit or something. He can stay in.
Okay.
Yeah, but so yeah,
potentially expose more people. Yeah, that's smart.
Well, they didn't. I had to talk to Dad, and Dad didn't need to fill out a pickup form or anything.
Okay.
So, I said, chances are you're going to be fine. Just go to the server and get some masks. Mum will be ready wearing masks. And you'll be fine. Just don't touch her. You'll be fine. So yeah, this one floor, you just multiply that by three, and that's, yeah, crazy. The amount of power these things fucking consume. It's like, yeah, I need to ramp up production, and it's like, I don't have enough power, then you have to... Which, to finish off this fuel production, I'm gonna have to expand my, fucking power generation by another 20 fucking...
Okay.
It's... very time consuming. It's fun. It makes you...
So, a sort of like a city builder game.
Kind of, in its own sense. Your entire goal is to harvest.
Yeah.
What people reckon it is, you're harvesting resources. You send the resources to unlock some certain tiers. You have to send up materials and shit to the space elevator.
Yep.
Which is, I haven't built one, but it's this massive fucking thing.
I'm actually back in my game at the moment. Give me a second.
So, I do have materials on me to build one. So if I pop it down here, I can delete it later. Are you watching?
Yeah, I'm watching. I'm coming over near.
Slowly building. All these materials are just floating out of me. It's... oh, they look... Alright, so that's down.
Okay,
where is
so
it?
Where's this elevator thing?
It's coming down now.
Oh, okay. I'll see it. Yeah.
Yeah, and this is what it's going to connect to. This big fucking thing down here.
That quad.
It's
going
to clip. It's going to clip through there, but yeah.
Cool.
It's just part of the structure.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Connects.
And so you send all everything you make back into space.
No.
Oh.
So I need to supply it with these extremely fucking time consuming. This is fucking like mid to late game fucking shit I need to produce, and I'm not even. So you need these to unlock tier 7 and tier 8.
Yeah.
So
what tier are
you
right there?
6.
Alright.
I think 7 and 8. I'm not going to be doing 7 and 8, because in an update 4, which is coming out I think sometime this year, they're changing things and adding stuff. So I thought ahead, and I'm like, before I start in like playing this game, I'm going to figure out if they're adding anything or change anything with the major update coming.
Yeah.
And they did. It's like, yes, some things in tier 7 and tier 8 are getting reworked and added into the game.
Yep.
So some of you, if you do have like mega factories, these factories are no longer going to be working.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, you pretty much seal it, then you send it off, then it gets flung up. Like, this does a whole magnetic charge thing, and it shoots it at that flying platform, and that goes back up to space.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, it's...
Cool.
Delete it.
It is a game on my wish list to get, so... One day I'll get it. When I don't have to worry about buying another frickin' car.
Fuck this, so...
Anyway, I'm going back to my game, because I'll really get back to the bubble tonight.
Yeah, I just turned flying on. This will give you an idea of how big this factory is. It's massive.
Well, so what, it's actually, what's that?
It's actually... this is the main factory that does the... I'm just flying. I've just turned flying on for a second.
Oh, okay. Wow. Okay.
So at the moment, I'm not using rubber and plastic. So what they're doing is they're going into... They're pretty much like scrapping, and this is the coupon, so you just like feed it and they give you coupons which you can use into a shop to buy stuff
To get you through, sort of thing,
to unlock certain things. If I fly back to my main base, it is a pretty big map, by the way.
It does look pretty big.
Flying Mantis.
Actually, no, that'd be more comparable to Ghost Recon Wildlands, I think.
Oh shit, it's moving too fast.
Mantis or Manta Ray?
Am I gonna hit it? Oh! Got it.
Cool.
A little baddies. So this thing you can't kill.
Why not?
Because it's part of the map.
Huh.
So let's go back to that store. So this is just my main base.
Alright, man.
It's kind of a fucking mess at the moment with... It's not organized. It's not...
Clearly.
It's not organized.
This doesn't resemble your bedroom, does it?
They go in here. Yeah, so use the coupons to unlock certain things.
Yeah.
Like, I just bought the windows and doors, and I'm not going
to
buy those.
To use,
and I didn't
want to
play this. So
I do see him. That's why it's so weird. I see him, and I see his symbol on the target, so I could manually target.
Let's have a look.
What I wanted to play is Cyberpunk. No, I don't want to.
Meanwhile, getting blown into pieces.
Is that...
Oh, we'll do what we can.
Yeah, if you have to jump out, jump out.
I'm trying to get everyone off everyone.
Yeah. Press U. Put your weapons away. Nah, he's gone. His shift is a... Yeah.
Well...
Sorry, Sensei.
Sorry, that's alright. I took my attention off for like 10 seconds.
Can't really do that with the vulture.
Yes.
Once your shield's gone, that's immediate. Turn away and just run.
Okay.
Pips the engines and shields and
abilities than the rebuy.
The rebuy is not going to be that much.
Yeah. So what might have been happening when you couldn't select his target, you're actually out of range?
Oh, the wing target, yeah. Not in range. Well, fuck, they fixed quite a bit of things.
Yeah, it was quite a big list.
None of the problems I know of are in that. Oh, one of them was. One of the missions, but yeah.
Yeah, I'm kind of half thinking about booting it up for a couple of hours.
So I see now, off of the target and him, 1.6k's away. Still, I press the hotkey and doesn't select it.
Yeah, so if you're out of range, it'll try to lock, but it won't be successful. So you'll have to be a lot closer. And it all depends on what your sensor range is.
There we go.
It depends on the sensor range. Yes. But 1.5k is generally okay, isn't it?
Depends on your sensor range. So, like my Corvette, I can do up to, I think,
what is it, 8? 7? 6? 7? Kilometers?
Do I want to run combat zones, or do I want to play some cyberpunk?
Sensei, I've just took on
combat zones.
I just took on 4 elite eagles and that elite crusader. I'm going to go and repair. I'll be right back.
Yeah, no worries.
I did it, but I'm just going to go and repair.
Yeah. Combat zones.
It's a safe bet.
Ooh, Dyson Sphere. I forgot about that game. That should have been released.
The only one I need to play is, or finish off playing is bloody Outer Worlds.
Yeah, I still need to go back and what I did is I saved, then I finished the game, and what I wanted to do is load the game and go back and kill everyone.
Just go down to town, take them all out.
Town to town, just fucking murdering everyone.
Yeah, because I was really taking my time with it, making sure I got all the missions done at each place.
I think I was missing probably a handful of missions that were skipped.
Yeah, deal.
But yeah, Dyson Sphere looks interesting.
Hmm.
Oh, it's on special, 10% off. No, I'm adding it to my wish list. Really should buy it now, but I don't want to.
I'll wait for the next sale, it'll be like 15% or 20% off.
No, because once it comes out of early access, it will go up to full price.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I hate early access games that ask for a retail price when it's early access.
Yeah.
So, you offer the game cheap, and people buy it, and get you started. And once it releases, people still, if it's a good game, people still fucking pay it.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Yeah. Done that with a few games. Probably one of the best successful ones was Kerbal Space Program. I got that really early on. I think it's like $10 or something like that.
$10-$15 or something, yeah.
And now it's like 30. What is it now? Kerbal.
$12 at the moment. $11.50 at the moment. Or the complete pack is $31.
Yeah.
32.
This one early access game that I got with a humble pack. It's called Rapture Rejects. I can't even play it because the friggin' servers are being taken down. Because the developers stopped working on it. And yet, they still sell it on Steam.
Yeah, there's a few games like that. So Steam needs to be kicked up the ass for a lot of things.
Absolutely.
So I've still got a hankering to play Fallout 3, but last time I tried it, it just wouldn't even boot.
But which one?
Fallout 3.
Oh, yep.
Then you go to the Steam page for it, and it's got a warning there now saying it doesn't run on anything after Windows 7. So, and you're still selling it? Fuck you guys.
And yet everyone's fine on my computer. We spoke about that a while ago.
Yeah, my hardware.
I was just going to say, I think you said something about
hardware,
video,
drivers.
Yeah, video cards, I think it was.
Very early on, because I played a lot of it, mainly originally, like even before I had a gaming PC, I used to borrow my brother's PlayStation, and I'd play it on that.
Oh, okay.
And then that's what really got me into, okay, yeah, I'm going to build a computer and get better graphics and all that sort of stuff. And the first game of all was Fallout 3.
Yeah.
Worked fine quite a while, and then I think it was my second build after that ran into heaps of problems where it just wouldn't run on the system.
Okay.
So I had to do a tweak in the config to tell it to run on multi-core, not two cores.
Yeah.
And then after that, it was fine. You still had your few buggy places, like you'd go into the Super Duvermar and it would crash on you most of the time, and that was just because that area was never optimized on the game side.
Oh, okay.
Played it for... was it around this time last year? No issues. And then a few months ago, went boot up, and it was just like, nah, not working anymore.
Wow. I assume that you've looked on forums to see if there was another workaround for it, did you?
I've done all that. What I've done now is actually deleted it and reinstalled it.
Yeah. And
it
still didn't
work. I did that anyway. I haven't tried it since then.
Oh, okay.
I ended up buying Outer Worlds and then played that for quite a bit and then kind of forgot.
Outer Worlds, that's a first person shooter, isn't it?
Yeah, it's made by the same developers who made Fallout New Vegas.
Oh,
Obsidian. So it's got that real New Vegas vibe to it. There's a real Firefly vibe as well. And basically, it's like New Vegas in space.
Oh, okay.
With a bit more comedy. It's, yeah, it's a really good game.
Man, I haven't even finished playing Fallout 3 yet.
I've
gotten as far as being on board the UFO and all that.
Oh, it's the DLC stuff.
Sorry?
The DLC.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, finished the main game several times, done the DLC several times. New Vegas is the one I played the most of.
Yeah.
Still gonna go back and finish that off. My last playthrough was to get the last four achievements, so I had 100% on it.
Okay.
And got to the end, finished it, and realized I had a mod running that I didn't realize I had installed. I'm like, no, I got no achievements because mods achievements are disabled if you got mods on.
What?
It was like one weapon mod.
It's a Skyrim or Fallout.
Pretty much all Bethesda games do that, but this was New Vegas. Have I seen this guy's stuff before?
Look, Mom, no computer. Yeah, I've seen the one where he does the Kirby keyboard.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, he's fucking brilliant.
Yep.
Actually, I think someone made a mod up for New Vegas where they basically rebuilt Fallout 3 inside of New Vegas using the mod engine in New Vegas.
I thought they rebuilt on the... was it number four?
Fallout
4. What's
this?
New
Vegas.
Yeah, New Vegas
project,
or number four, yeah. I remember reading about it a while ago, though.
Mod?
Yeah, so
they
basically rebuilt Fallout 3 in either or Fallout
4. Fallout 4 Capital Wasteland.
Yeah. Was it? Okay.
Which, yeah, they've done a heap of progress on that.
Yeah.
It may be coming out later this year. Because obviously with what happened in 2020 and still what's going on at the moment, they've had a lot of time to sit at home and work on it.
Yeah.
It would have been out by now if they were allowed to use the original audio.
Sorry, Sensei, I just bumped you, I think.
They've had to go through and... re-record all of the dialogue tracks.
Oh, okay.
Copyright issues.
Yep.
So they started doing a bit with it, and then they actually approached Bethesda and go, hey, we're doing this mod. Are we allowed to use this audio? And they're like, yeah, nah, that's going to be copyright infringement if you do.
Yeah.
So rather than scrapping the whole project, they actually went and hired voice actors to go and re-record all of the audio for it. Same group that are doing the New Vegas one, they've same thing.
Yep.
And like you listen to some of the side by side comparison, like shit, sounds like the same voice actor. Like they've done a really damn good job.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, can't wait for that to come out and the New Vegas one. Especially so I can run away from those goddamn cazadors.
I thought that they already completed the Fallout 3 mod for New Vegas or whatever.
No.
Okay.
And then the other one is Fallout Miami. That looks absolutely fantastic.
So that's just a different story made up by someone, is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
So again, using the Creation 4 engine, which is the Fallout 4 one, building a whole new world.
Yeah.
And this one's set in Miami. It's like a AAA kind of title. They've done really damn well with it. Like even the I still haven't found the trailer for it.
I've got a feeling I've heard about the Miami one, but yeah.
What is it, Fallout Miami, whatever it was called?
Hey?
Fallout Miami.
Yeah.
Okay.
The official reveal trailer. Yeah, that's it.
I'm gonna grab an elite cover on my three. I'll be right back.
No worries.
No, sorry, as in I'm gonna pull him back to Sensei. Sorry, I should be more specific in what I'm saying.
Welcome
back.
Yeah,
I've already seen that one.
Yeah. This looks absolutely awesome. And like the trailer looks like something that Bethesda could have done.
Kind of thought it was a real game then.
Oh, it is a real game. It's just the Fallout 4 engine, but different location.
Didn't Stick say he was going to be sitting there playing that game until 10 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, he's a bit worn out from doing that the night before. It's kind of why I had an afternoon nap after my drive today.
Yeah.
Now contemplating, do I play some more Elite? Do I play some Cyberpunk for a bit?
Okay.
Not sure. Do you kind of want to see how this new update has made the game?
So you're still in the late right now, eh? Or?
Yeah, just sitting on the carrier.
No.
Contemplating. Maybe I'll just run a few.
Bastard!
Yeah, I know.
Sounds like something good just happened.
Ah, oh, and there was an elite crusader just jumped out. We had him almost down to nothing, too.
Okay.
Guys wanted.
I'm just giving my shield a second.
It says it's sensor, but like, I can see everyone. They're definitely on the radar.
Actually, no, you can't. Bob, you know, even if your range is like 12Ks like mine, is there still things outside that distance?
It just doesn't do anything. Like, it still targets the same target I was targeting manually. supposed to target what you are targeting.
Yeah, if I'm this close, with this close, it's fine.
Since I've left Beagle Point, I have done a honk in every system and had a quick look to see if anything was worth scanning or not. But before I died, I didn't do that. Not in every system.
So you think you got a lot more data to sell now?
I sold most of it. I actually sold all of it when I got to Explorer's Anchorage.
Smart, yes.
It was nearly 1 billion credits worth.
Ah.
Nice.
I was 7 million short.
Just not good enough.
up to last night, I was back up to about 120 or 150 million or something.
Nice. And I'm almost out of ammo, so maybe one more sensei.
Okay.
Is there anything decent nearby? Elite Vulture incoming.
Welcome back.
What was that evil cackle for? Well, that's 44 million in bounties for me. I think I might call it a night.
No worries.
Any preferences of where to hand this into Varys, or just have a look at the orders?
Oh, it's a little hard at the moment. I dropped some into Morrowing. You're welcome to drop it there as well.
Morrowing? Can do.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sensei.
First case there, we'll get into conflict with one of the other player factions, but it won't be a Lavini's Legion. And looks like this Imperial Pilot Society are trying to make a move on the system. and that'll kind of stop it for him. And I'm gonna Braven Tunnel.
Lovely.
Yep. Oh, I wish that would fix this already. Yep.
You know what I've been experiencing a bit of lately?
What's that?
You go to load up the system map, and it just hangs. So to...
Okay.
To get out of it, I have to quit back to the main menu and then reload the game again. I don't know why it's been doing that, but man.
Yeah, probably tweaking with background code.
Or it just could be my shitty internet.
I wouldn't think your net would have an issue on that.
You wouldn't think so, but man. Who knows? With the lovely NBN. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the NBN, right?
No, I've never been. Ever. It works perfect all the time.
Yeah, fantastic, isn't it?
Mine works now since they fixed the damn thing, but that took them months to get around to doing.
So when the gimbal is like all confused, that means they are chafing, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So just hold fire for a sec.
Yeah.
Either that or deselect the target and just shoot at them manually.
Uh-huh.
And your weapon will act as a fixed weapon.
Oh, interesting.
Also, if you're very close, you're probably going to hit anyway.
Especially larger targets. If uh-huh. you're right on them, yeah, you're still going to hit them.
Yeah, I couldn't get this thing to work, to target my wingman's target at all. I don't know why. I was much quicker just selecting it myself with the target ahead.
It usually only has issues if you're out of range, or say if you're in normal space and your wingmate's in super cruise, then that's not going to work.
But we were both in normal space, like next to each other, like maybe a kilometer or two away.
Might just be your target. Senses.
Check what senses I have on this.
Yeah, just check their range. I mean, are you have D radar sensors, A radar sensors? What do you have?
Sensors E.
E. Okay, I would at least upgrade them to D's. For combat ship, you may want to consider A's because it gives you the long range. They're heavy, but they give you long range.
Mm-hmm. Or alternatively, go with D's and get the engineering to do your long range sensors. Mm-hmm. That's generally what I run with.
8 km typical emission range, 4.4. So it's definitely like every metric is beyond the 1.5.
Yeah, but 4.4 typical emissions is not a long way. That's probably why you're having difficulty.
Yeah, so that's just out of your weapons range.
I mean, I think I've got long range A's on this, so my typical emissions range is 12 km on this, if I recall correctly, something like that, so.
So what, like, hang on a sec. So let me understand this. So... I assume effective range is the typical emission range, is that right? No?
So where are you seeing that written? Is that in-game or in, like, Coriolis or in R?
Like, in-game. Like, when I look at my sensors on my right hand side panel, that's what it says.
Okay, hang on, let me look at mine, just make sure I'm talking about the same thing. Yeah, because if I look on mine on the right hand side, I've got maximum range, typical emission range. Are you seeing those two? So on mine, I've got what, a 4A long range. So my maximum range is 14 kilometers. My typical emission range is 11.7. So I'm going to be spying targets from the other end of the zone. Right? What does yours say?
It says 8 and 4.4.
Yeah. So look, for things like, you know, bounty hunting missions and stuff like that, where you're jumping, you know, that's fine. I would recommend upgrading minimum to a D.
Uh-huh. I'm having a lot of trouble with Padro though. Like, that's part of the reason why it's an E, because like it's already overdrawing power left and right, and it already has an A power plan.
Yeah, so you're gonna have to play around with your power priorities.
Yeah, that's what I did. It's a pain in the bum.
Yeah, it is. So what you might have to do is actually put your frameshift drive on a lower priority, so when you drop out and you got your weapons deployed, that'll actually shut down, and it should give you a lot more power.
That's exactly what I did.
Other thing is engineering. That's definitely going to make a huge difference.
I know. That's definitely the answer,
Yeah, see, on mine, I've got things like I've got an interdictor and a fuel scoop on this, so I put pump dies of those to 5. So you know, when I'm in combat, I don't need them anyway. And that just gives me enough to power everything that I need without putting my frame shift drive to priority 5. So,
And so emission range, is that the effective range?
What the typical emissions range is not documented.
Okay.
What people presume it is if you can consider an average ship doing average things, right?
Yeah.
However, certain ships, like larger ships, are detectable at longer range. Detects ships that are hotter, like firing weapons or something like that, are detectable at a longer range. Ships that are smaller or colder, you may need to be closer to detect. Things like Thargoids are always detected maximum range because they're so freaking big. And yes, you will find in this game that you can see further than the range of your sensors. Yes, that is how the game works.
Oh no, so I was seeing the your target with purple on my radar. Right, so I assume that's sensor range. Or not.
Yeah, if it appears on your radar, it should be in a sensor range, yes.
Yeah, and that's why I was confused. Why is the targeting my wingman's target function not working?
I'm not sure, but I would recommend upgrading to bigger sensors still.
Yeah. Yeah, generally anything that's E-rated, you'll just get rid of and go to the next best thing.
Because most people go Ds because they are the lightest of all the grades, so.
Yeah.
And they're better than Es, generally, anyway. So what most people do in most ships, most of the time, will go D-rated life support and D-rated sensors and A-rate everything else. In combat ships, you may want to consider A-rating your sensors, because I have, just because I'm in a man, but my job is to see things and get to them fast. So hence, I have big sensors in mind.
Fair enough.
Particularly on the compromised nav beacon like that, or in Azure sites, having the longer range sensors helps as well, because stuff all over the place. I mean, your regular V5 ships are 15 kilometers away. So, yeah.
So what exactly does compromise mean in the navigation beacon's case? Like, who compromised it and what does that change?
So it means the security forces won't appear.
Right.
So generally, if you're in a normal nav beacon and you get into combat with a wanted ship, and particularly if you've got report crimes turned on, the security ships will appear after a certain period of time.
I see.
Depending on the threat level. And compromise basically means that's been disabled, so the security aren't aware of what's going on in there and they will never jump in.
It's like the difference between a hazardous resource extraction zone and a high resource extraction zone. In a hazardous security one, it will never jump in, so.
So I just scanned the ship and it says wanted, but it's EDA Kunti League Assassin. How does that
doesn't matter.
Like,
wanted,
they are lawless?
Yeah.
If they're wanted, they're fair game irrespective of the faction. If they're clean, that's a whole different rule game.
Sure.
Yeah, so killing clean ships will give you notoriety. Which, for every 1 point of notoriety is 2 hours of in-game gameplay.
What does that 2 hours mean? You have to play 2 hours clean?
2 hours until it counts down.
Right.
And while you have notoriety, you a lot of station options will not be available to you. You may have security ships come after you.
Diminished right. Missions as well, so you might get the best missions. And depending on your level of notoriety, say if you're upwards of 10 and you commit more crimes, you're going to have the ATR ships come after you, and they're very extremely heavy engineered, usually vultures, and they will destroy you within a couple shots.
Fun.
Yeah, they're the kind of stopgap to stop players from absolutely pounding on the system security constantly.
Right.
And so what they'll do is they'll take a shield generator, and then within seconds you're absolute toast.
What are they called again?
ATR. Advanced ATR. Tactical Response.
Fair enough.
Yeah, and they even have little flashing sirens. Lights. Most people don't realize that until you can actually get up close to them. So, found that out recently. Like, holy shit, they got the lights and everything. And yeah, you don't mess with them.
So, Devera is just confirming selling these vouchers, 44 million at Mariang.
Yep, away. That's fine.
Done.
And that should possibly push us into conflict with the Imperial Pilot Society, and then that'll stop them creeping on Lavini's Legion.
Alright, Fox, thanks for the games.
Not a problem.
Catch you later.
Yep.
Yeah, Sherry.
So you're up.
See ya. I'm about halfway across the inner Orion Spur now, so...
Ah, very good. Be here in no time.
Yeah, not quick enough. Send your carrier out to pick me up, will
you? I don't think I got enough fuel for that.
Okay. I'm 4,200 light years away. Jumps. Getting there.
Shift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging.
System scan complete.